In this illustration, we'll analyze the de Broglie wavelength and frame of center of mass. Here we are given that two identical non-relativistic particles move at right angle to each other possessing de Broglie wavelengths lambda 1 and lambda 2. Here we are required to find the de Broglie wavelengths of both particles in the reference frame attached to their center of mass. Here in solution we can write, as we are given that these particles move at right angle to each other, here we can see if this is a coordinate system and along x and y axis the two particles are moving, they are having mass m and one is moving with a velocity v1 and other is moving with a velocity v2 and both are identical, so we can take equal mass. So here we can calculate the velocity of center of mass of particles. This can be directly given as vc is equals to this m1 v1 plus m2 v2 upon m1 plus m2. So this gives us m v1 I cap plus m v2 j cap divided by m plus m is 2m. So the velocity of center of mass we are getting is v1 I cap plus v2 j cap divided by 2. Now if we calculate the velocity of first particle with respect to center of mass, then this velocity of first particle with respect to center of mass we can write v1 vector minus vc vector. On substituting the value of vc over here, this will give us v1 I cap minus v2 j cap by 2. Similarly, we can calculate velocity of second particle with respect to center of mass. This v2 with respect to center of mass can again be given as v2 vector minus vc vector. So this will give us v2 j cap minus v1 I cap divided by 2. As we have got the values of v1c and v2c, now we can calculate the de Broglie wavelength of particles with respect to center of mass, as we can write lambda of 1 with respect to center of mass will be h by momentum of a particle 1 with respect to center of mass, which is mv1c. Here we can substitute the magnitude of v1c, so this gives us h divided by m multiplied by the magnitude of v1c is root of v1 square plus v2 square by 2. So this is root of v1 square plus v2 square by 2. So here we can substitute v1 and v2 by lambda 1 and lambda 2, as we are given that lambda 1 is the de Broglie wavelength of first particle, which is h over mv1, and lambda 2 is given as h over mv2. So if we substitute the values here, it is 2h by m multiplied by under the root of v1 we can write as h over m lambda 1 whole square plus v2 is h over m lambda 2 whole square. On simplifying this relation, we'll get the wavelength lambda 1c is equals to 2 lambda 1 lambda 2 divided by root of lambda 1 square plus lambda 2 square. That is one result of the problem. And similarly, we can calculate lambda of a second particle with respect to center of mass, which is h by mv2c. And here you can see the magnitude of v2c is same as that of v1c. So de Broglie wavelength here is 2h by again m root of v1 square plus v2 square. And on substituting the same values here, you can see this 2h by m root of h by m lambda 1 square plus h by m lambda 2 square. And on simplifying, this is again giving us the same value twice of lambda 1 lambda 2 by root of lambda 1 square plus lambda 2 square, that is the result of this problem.